blessing Chidinma Amadi. February 2018. Like a young girl, I woke up happy and decided for school. I was ready to meet my teachers and friends. We were in the class that morning, and suddenly there was this screaming from the other class. Well, it was usual because students would normally scream when there was something awkward. But gradually the screaming increased and became very unusual. You know, it got louder. But I just ignored it. My teacher actually, she went out to check what was happening. And when she opened the door, we saw people screaming, running and crying. And then a few minutes later, we heard a gunshot. It was a familiar sound to the ones I hear in Hollywood movies. So I was sure it was a gunshot. Yes, I panicked. Our teacher asked us to stay down on our desks. So, my best friend was actually crying. But I was still very confused. Our teacher, she's a brave woman. So she tried to close the door to keep us safe inside. But before she could do that, I noticed a foot in slippers covered in mud, preventing the door from closing. And I looked up, we had two military men. Called them military because they were wearing military clothes. But then I was wondering why they weren't wearing their shoes. However, I was relieved, very much relieved, that whatever it was happening, those people were there to keep us safe. Before I could be happy, one of the men dressed in military attire slapped our teacher. She fell down unconscious. The next thing that followed was a gunshot at the ceiling. And the men ordered us to stay down. That was when I realized we were in for trouble. That was when everything began to make sense to me. The screaming of usually. The men in military attire, but in slippers. We are not military men, and they were not there to keep us safe. So there was no reason to be happy. In fact, I then realized there was every reason to cry. And I began to cry. The men asked us to tie our eyes with our scarves. They shot at the ceiling once more and ordered us to keep quiet so that nobody gets hurt. They made us line up and hold each other's shoulder and moved out of the classroom, going to where I didn't know. The school compound was quiet. Perhaps people had escaped. Or maybe the other students had been captured. So we marched off to school about 300 meters away, and we got to this really noisy place. Just the sound of an engine, like that of a truck. And suddenly a man, muscular and smelly, lifted me off my feet and threw me behind. Just when we started moving, I staggered a bit and fell on my friends. That was when I realized it was a truck. And that was when I confirmed it was not a good one. That moment, I felt even more terrified. I wanted to be free. I wanted freedom that moment. I wanted freedom more than ever. I could give anything to be taken away from that scene, because it was a very terrifying situation and I didn't know where we were heading to. What happened was that my mom woke me up and said, "Hey, you need to get ready for school." Yes, it was a dream. It is my dream. It was a nightmare. But I know many people who this nightmare is their reality. Many girls who have been kidnapped, many boys and girls who have been sold to slavery, they have no freedom. I think that we should be able to dream about our future and have an opportunity to walk towards that future without constraints. We should have the safety. We should have this sense of freedom, and not just about the word, but the practical sense of it. And this is my definition of freedom. Today is my freedom day. And this is our freedom day.